Hey guys, here's what we're building today. This is the official GTA 6 website, and we will be recreating it in Bootstrap Studio. The design has smooth animations that play on scroll and features images and videos from the game. Today we'll build the hero section and a couple of the character bios. We'll leave the rest for a future video. We begin with a blank design. The first step is to import the images that we'll need. You can find them linked in the video description. The website we are building has a dark color scheme, so we'll switch the entire design to dark mode from the settings. Another thing we need to change is the font. The one on the GTA website is custom made, but we can substitute it with the Montserrat family from Google Fonts. Remember to include the bold version as well. This'll import the font, but to apply it to the design, we need to set it in the theme panel. Switch to dark mode and apply it in the font settings. I will also set the text and background colors. Let's switch to the GTA website again and take a closer look at the animations. When we scroll down, we see that the background image scales down, the logo and play button fade out, and then a cutout effect is applied. This fades into a colorful version of the logo with intro text. To build this in the app, we need to install a component from the online library. It's called Scroll Animation, and it lets you create effects that are synced to the scrolling of the page. You'll see how it works in a moment. First, we need to drop a section in the page. This'll hold the scroll animation. We'll give it an ID of hero. Then create a block and give it a height of 600 VH. This will make it take 6 screens of vertical space. Now drop the scroll animation component we just installed and remove the label. The green icon indicates that it has custom options, which you can see here. This is where we will configure the scroll effects. We'll come back to this in a moment. We'll need a few more scroll animations to recreate the effect from the GTA website. I'll duplicate the one we have. We'll nest them like this. Let's give them IDs to tell them apart. We'll call them Mask, Background, Overlay, and Content. I'll create a new CSS block for the background effect. A 100 VH height will make it take the entire browser window. I'll also give it a background. It needs to be centered and the size set to cover. Now the image takes the full width and height of the element and adapts to screen size. We'll follow the same steps for the content animation. Set the height to 100 VH. For the background, I'll choose text.webp. This image is the same width and height as the last one and consists of a logo on a transparent background. Center it and set it to cover. This image is prepared in such a way that the letters of the logo match precisely with the outlines of the character, giving the illusion of depth. Now, let's animate this. As I mentioned earlier, the scroll animation component defines a number of custom options. With these, you can build impressive animation effects that track the scroll position of the page. Activate the sticky option. This'll keep the component fixed on the screen while we scroll, so it can be modified with other effects. Then, in the opacity field, write 1, 1, and 0 separated by commas. This will make the component start with full opacity, stay that way until the midpoint, then will gradually fade to 0 and become invisible. You can think of each number as a keyframe in the animation. I will also limit the animation to take effect from the top of the screen until 200 VH, which is 2 screen heights. Let's see it in the browser. We can see that the element is fully visible for a bit, then fades out 2 screen heights down, which is exactly what we want. For the background image, we will apply a scale animation. We'll start at 1.2, then scale down to 1 at the end. The animation will run from the top of the screen until 150 VH down. In the browser, the image scales down like we intended. But there is a problem. Since we're scaling up the image at the start, it exceeds the horizontal space available, which results in a horizontal scroll bar. We can fix this by selecting the parent component and setting overflow to hidden. For the text, we want it to fade out earlier than the background image. So I'll write 100. This will make the element fully transparent at the halfway point of the scroll. The animation will be active from the top to 100 VH. So far, the animation looks pretty good. Now we come to the most interesting part, the mask. We imported an SVG file earlier, which we'll use for this purpose. When we set it as a mask, the white parts will be visible and everything else will be hidden. This will result in a cutout with the shape of the logo. We will write a bit of CSS in the editor. Create a block and use the mask CSS rule and select the image. Turn off the repeat and center it. Right now, the image is too small, which is where the mask size property comes in. The basic idea is that we will start with a large mask size value and decrease it on scroll. I'll set it to 4000%. To make it animate on scroll, I'll use the mask size custom option to make it scale down to 300 pixels midway and stay there until the end. Let's see it in the browser. The animation is taking shape. Now we want the cutout to smoothly transition into this image. To turn the cutout white, we will use the overlay component. Select it and create a CSS block. We'll give it a white background and have it take the full width and height of the parent element. We'll hide it with opacity 0. In the animation options, we will start from 0 and transition to full opacity in the latter half of the animation. Now the logo transitions to white, but we'll have to find a way to display the rest of the graphic. We can achieve this by adding another scroll animation that holds the colorful logo and fades in at a specific point. Duplicate the last animation and place it inside the section. Change the ID to intro. I'll hide the mask so it doesn't get in the way. Now drop the logo image and give it an ID of logo color. I'll set it to a width of 300 by 200 pixels. I'll also create a CSS block and give it a bottom margin. Then select the parent and set text alignment to center. Drop a heading for the intro text. I've prepared a document with the text to save some typing. You can find it linked in the description. I'll also copy some CSS to style the heading with a gradient. Add the PS5 and Xbox logos under the heading. Resize them while holding Shift to maintain the ratio. Add some margin around the images. Also under the heading. To center the logo vertically, we can apply a top margin like this. VHS is half the screen height. The image is 200 pixels tall, so subtracting 100 will put the image exactly in the center. Now we will apply some scroll effects. We want the graphic to fade in as the cutout fades out. We will also apply a scale down effect. And we'll move it up with Translate. You can play with these values in the finished design in the video description. Unhide the mask and switch to the browser. The animation looks great and is very close to the one in the GTA 6 website. Let's build the navigation bar. We'll add a nav element, give it an ID, and make it fixed to the top of the screen with a bit of CSS. The z-index will make it always appear on top of the other content. Drop the logo SVG and resize it. Then follow with the menu SVG. We'll give some padding to the navigation and switch it to display flex. Click Modify to access the Flexbox panel. We can center and spread out the two images like this. We won't be recreating the menu of the GTA website today, since it can take an entire video on its own. Write a comment below if you would like to see it on our channel. Now, we can move on to the two character sections. Drop a section component in the body and give it a class name. Then add the one row, two columns component inside it. We'll also add a couple of headings in a paragraph. Copy the bio from the text file. Make the first heading an H2 and set display to 4. Make the second heading H3 and set it to display 6. I'll also paste a few styles. Drop a new scroll animation in the right column. Then insert the images of the first character. I'll give a bottom margin to the top image. Select the row and spread out the columns with the gutter setting on the LG size. I'll use the Translate Y property to animate the right column. This will give the impression of layers with different scrolling speed. The Sync property will make the animation smoother. Let's see it in the browser. You can see that the Sync property keeps the animation going for a bit after we stop scrolling. If you like how it looks, you can enable it on all animations we did so far. Now let's create the bio section for the other character. Use the Ctrl plus D keyboard shortcut on Windows or Command plus D on Mac. This will duplicate the entire section and place it after the first. Replace the text. Change the images. Finally, switch the columns around. We can now move on to the footer. I will use the footer dark component from the library. Drop it inside the body and change the text of the links. Apply a few styling tweaks from the text options to make it uppercase and bold. And remove the underline. Add the rating image and resize it. Give it some space. We'll finish this video by adding a YouTube player for the game trailer. We will use another component from the online library called Overlay Video Player. Install it and drop it inside the content div. Hide the intro so it doesn't get in the way. Change the thumbnail image to play.svg. Select the link and replace the YouTube URL with the one of the trailer. Remove the shadow and activate autoplay in the options. This will make the video play immediately when it's shown in the overlay. Lastly, we'll center it with the flex group. We'll remove most of the CSS in the Overlay Video Player style sheet. Then, increase the scale on hover a bit. I'll also enlarge the play image. The last thing left is to show the intro again. And with this, our website is ready. Clicking the play button loads the game trailer. Scrolling down animates the page and smoothly transitions between the hero and logo. Then we have the character bios. And finally, the footer. Thank you for watching this video. You can find the finished design and assets in the description. What would you like to see next time? Leave a comment below.